Nana Saheb Peshwa, the lion-hearted Peshwa of the Maratha Empire. Nana Saheb was the son of Narayan Bhat and Ganga Bai. After the Marathas were defeated in the Third War, the East India Company exiled Bajirao to Bithor, where he maintained a large establishment. Nana's father had travelled to Bajirao's court to become a court official of the Peshwa. The Peshwa Bajirao, who was lacking sons, adopted Nana and his younger brother. A rule was implemented to deal with properties. It stated that any property under the British rule will be annexed if the ruler dies without an heir. So after Bajirao Peshwa passed away, in his will was Nana. But the company stopped the pensions as Nana was adopted. Nana, who was deeply offended, sent Azimullah Khan, his envoy, to England in order to plead his case. But unfortunately, he was unable to convince the British. After a patient wait, Nana won the confidence of the collector of Kanpur and agreed to arrange 1,500 soldiers to support the British. But after entering the British artillery, he changed sides and took the company's treasury under his control. This was when he decided to capture Kanpur. On 6th June 1857, Nana Saheb attacked the company's entrenchment. They caught the enemies off guard successfully, but the company could defend itself as the Indian soldiers were hesitant to enter the entrenchment as they were made to believe that it had gunpowder and may explode. Though they didn't enter it, the East India Company lost many lives due to sunstroke and lack of water. Seeing Nana's success, many rebels joined him, and now Nana was leading an army of 12,000 to 15,000 soldiers. On 16th July 1857, the East India Company attacked Nana's forces and recaptured Kanpur from him. Nana prepared to leave, and before escaping, he blew up the entire Kanpur artillery. Nana Saheb then disappeared without leaving a trace. His general attacked the British and tried to capture Kanpur again, but unfortunately he failed. After Nana left Kanpur, no one knew where he was. There are numerous reports though which claim Nana's presence. On September 1857, Nana was reported to have a fever. In 1859, he was reported to have been in Nepal. Few other reports claim that he died after being attacked by a tiger, and others say he was captured by the British. He was also said to have been in Istanbul. When Nana Saheb vanished, many old men turned themselves into the British, claiming that they were none other than Nana Saheb. Till today, the ultimate fate of Nana Saheb is unknown. Though we do not know how this courageous and determined hero spent his last days, the least we can do is be grateful and look up to him as our role model. Let Nana Saheb's great and prominent sacrifice not go to waste. Let his contribution to this land be remembered forever. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Dhanyavad.